Hello students, in the lecture number 3 of Petroleum Refining and Engineering, we'll start the discussion with the world's largest refineries. So normally the world's largest refineries are categorized in three ways. The first way is to have the total processing capability of a given refinery. So say for example, there is one petroleum refinery company and it is having multiple refineries across the globe. And the total sum of all the processing capability of crude oil is considered to have the ranking as the world's largest refineries. So as per that, the ExxonMobil company is having the world's largest processing capability of the crude oil across the globe. The second category we'll consider as the crude oil processing capability of a petroleum refinery at a given location. So in this category, instead of considering all the refineries across the globe of a given company, the location-wise processing capability of the crude oil is considered. Say for example, Reliance Jamnagar is the world's largest petroleum refinery as far as the location category is considered. That means the Reliance Jamnagar is having the world's largest petroleum crude oil processing capacity at a single location. Then the third category is the world's largest refinery in terms of a given production line. So what is the meaning of this? Say for example, if we choose any one petroleum refinery, say for example, Reliance Jamnagar. So Reliance Jamnagar is having two production lines. One is of 33 MMTPA capacity and second is of 28 MMTPA. So in order to make the ranking, we can take only 33 MMTPA of the refinery. So that means for a given production line, the refineries which are having world's largest capacity, that will be considered. And it is with the Paraguana Petroleum Refinery. Then we'll discuss about the world's largest petrochemical industries, and you will find that all the typical giant chemical industries are the part of the petrochemical industries. And we'll also see that there is only one company, that is ExxonMobil, which is in the top 10 category of exploration and production, refineries, as well as the petrochemicals. Then next point would be related to the discussion about the Fortune 500 global industries, and we'll see the top 10 industries for the last 4 years, and we'll conclude that more than 50% of the industries are crude oil based industries as far as the top 10 Fortune 500 industries are concerned. At the end, I will also show that the profit of top 10 companies of the Fortune 500. And you will be surprised that as far as the profits are concerned, always the top 1, 2, and 3 companies are from the crude oil based industries. So that means there is a huge profit margin involved in the crude oil companies. And from that, we'll discuss about the contribution of the hydrocarbon industries in the world economy. In the second part of the lecture, we'll discuss about the current trends going on in the crude oil industries. And the first one is the forward and backward integrations. What is the meaning of forward integration? Suppose there is an exploration and production company, that means oil exploration company, and if that company expands the business in petroleum refineries followed by petrochemicals, then it is considered as the forward integration. In the same way, if the petrochemical company expands their business into the refineries and then to the exploration and oil, then it is to be considered as the backward integration. Second, current trends we'll discuss that in the petrochemical companies, the specialty chemical production is being installed more and more. So for that, based on the R&D, based on the customer requirement, n number of specialty chemical manufacturing is being added in the petrochemical complexes. Another current trend would be the usage of the latest technologies. Because of so many expansion and forward integration, backward integration, all the chemical engineering principles are involved into the refineries and petrochemicals. Whatever latest technologies are in the area of chemical engineering, you will find in the refineries and petrochemicals. And the last current trend we'll discuss would be the revamping of the refineries. So the revamping means the expansion and modernization of the petroleum refineries. So this is all about the lecture number 3.